y'all said blitzball couldn't exist. Have you heard of the torpedo leagues?
Get down here, Murph.
Found your own justice. This memorable day marks your graduation from your thoughts.
Yo, what's good on what you in the web? This is your man Q back again with some more of that geek news. Before we go any further, and if you're new to the channel and you want to stay up to date with all things games, entertainment, anime, sprinkle with a little bit of that comedy, make sure you subscribe. It's free 99. We on a Christmas Day miracle. Hashtag road 1K. It's free. I also stream over on Twitch. Links are in the description below. RPGs, check. Smash Brothers, check. Nintendo, check. Simulation, check. Many of y'all hate Blitzball and always wonder how they were gonna make it work when humans can't breathe underwater. Well, in all actuality, I've been knowing this for a minute, and one of the reasons I was out here defending Blitzball for forever, not to mention that each time I play Final Fantasy X, I put at least an average of 20 to 30 hours in Blitzball just by itself. But 5 minutes is actually just a drop in the bucket compared to the 24 minutes the World Guinness Book Record winner, holder, Alex Sergio Vendero of Barcelona, Spain, set the bar high at 24 minutes and 3 seconds in February 16. And there's even special training that you can do to withstand and hold your breath longer. One of my favorite animes is on my list, which nobody talks about, Beck, Mongolian Chop Squad. The lead protagonist, Koyuki, is a singer, and in order to bring up and help his capacity of holding notes longer, he starts taking up swimming, which helps him expand his lungs, which therefore helps him hold his breath longer, you know? So it's training that you can actually do. When I seen this online torpedo league, basically the real life version of Blitzball, I had to talk about it and I had to come out on these digital streets and defend Blitzball once again. Cause yes, it could be done. Yes, you can hold your breath for up to 5 minutes. And yes, if Blitzball was a real thing, like its own standalone game, I'm pretty sure you play it.
You're out of your league. You're out of your league. You're out of your league. You can't do it, kid.
Oh, come on! Did I get it? Finally! Get off me. Get off me.
The best? Yeah, right.
Whoa! What's that called?
Doesn't have an
end. Thank you.
Anyone can do it if they try.
Show us one more time, yeah?
7 times. That's my favorite number. It took 7 times. GG. That's my favorite number. It's like Blitzball, but then it has some differences. I'll put the link in the description below in case y'all want to check it out. Like, I can swim, but I can't swam like that to be doing no Blitzball underwater. I ain't Tetis. The object of the game is to move the torpedo underwater and place the torpedo in the opposing team's goal without committing a foul. That sounds very familiar, except in Blitzball, you just punch, kick, wither, and poison shot somebody in order to get the ball. Each game consists of 3 matches. Each match is played with a point scoring round that is played to have 5 points per match. The team that reaches 5 points first wins the match. The team that wins 2 of the 3 matches wins the game. Games will begin when the torpedo in the middle of the pool, that sounds just like Blitzball, and you're able to move the torpedo by swimming with it and handing it off or passing it to another team member while submerged. However, the person in possession of the torpedo must remain underwater and no part of the body may come up to the water while possession of the torpedo. This is probably the closest we're going to get to Blitzball without having baggy shorts, spiky hair, and a sphere shot. And that got me to thinking, what if Blitzball was a standalone game? And I don't mean it has to be a standalone game on the PlayStation 5 or the Xbox or Switch or a AAA title. I mean, what if in this mobile game climate, Blitzball was an actual game? See, the problem with Blitzball wasn't that Blitzball was bad. It was that they made the mechanics of Blitzball bad. Mainly because you can't control your character in Blitzball. You have to stop, go to a menu screen, and then you can't really dictate the defense or the offense how you want. It's just really based on a RNG type of random number system where if someone has a 75 goalie block or catch and you have a 100 kick or shot, the 75 sometimes can still randomly beat it. And I get they were trying to make the game competitive, but it really wasn't competitive. And that turned a lot of people off. If you're a grinder like me, you probably do like Blitzball. Some of the best features in Blitzball need to be adapted in other RPGs and other, not just sports mini games, but mini games in general. One of the perks about it is over the whole world of Spyro, you were able to go and pick up different people from different regions and have contracts with those characters. And whoever was good, well, of course, they're going to demand more money. And then you would even see certain players go to other opposing teams. I could see this being even bigger than the 6 teams that they had in Spyro, and you could add at least 4 more teams, or if you wanted to do like 20 teams, that was like on a cell phone type thing, and then you can go around the world and just basically recruit different players within like an MMO type setting, almost kind of like how Pokemon Unite is, you know, where you're going around and collecting different things. You see different players, you might talk to them and do or unlock certain situations in the game that allows you to get those characters, or it could just be straight like NBA, Madden, or baseball, where there's a set amount of teams and then those contracts are up and then you can have different types of players who are on those teams. And now Final Fantasy, since Final Fantasy X, there's a lot more characters and races and species that Blitzball could use. You can have Moogles, you could have Vera, you can have the Sikhs, you can have the, I forgot their names, but the Elven races. There's a lot of characters that you would be able to have other than just the Humes within it. I actually can see Blitzball being brought back, if not in a cell phone game, to be brought back in the MMO behemoth, which is Final Fantasy 14. As much as folks love Endwalker and as much as folks love Final Fantasy 14, if you threw a Blitzball game in that series, I guarantee people would like it and people would play it more, especially if you just change a few of the mechanics. Take that RNG crap out of it and actually make it a base number system. If you have a high attack, it beats the high defense. If you have a high catch, it beats the lower, you know, the lower stats. And then you will still be able to go to the different regions in Final Fantasy 14 or even on a cell phone based game and do that. Even you can even connect those two together if you want, and it'll almost be not a huge deal for a company like Square Enix to do that because they already have the base resources there to do it. You know, I think it'll be a good idea. I think it'll be a good game. And I think that Blitzball needs more representation because we got such a sad sample size from the first one. And then the second one was even worse because it was just Dino. Most of y'all probably hate Blitzball and never ever want to see anything again. But think about it. If you just changed a few mechanics, the game could actually be good, especially if it's not forced behind like a slots or pay thing or wall. You could even have like certain characters on Final Fantasy 14 show up where you would have Waka's gear and Tidus's gear and Riku's gear and Shinra's gear that you can use to play Blitzball. I mean, that could even be a class. Just these ideas is free, y'all. They free, Square Enix.
The best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
Webb, what do you think? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you're new to my channel, you want to stay up to date with all things games and all things geek, please make sure you hit that that subscribe button. It's free to do so. Please. Just if you like the content. If you don't like it, I understand. I appreciate you getting this far. If you do want to see some games like Final Fantasy 14, 10, 11, 12, 13, all them things, plus a whole bunch of other RPGs, you can follow me over on Twitch. Links are in the description below. I stream Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. Tuesday, Thursday, even on Saturday. 3 days of the week. Remember to eat, sleep, geek, repeat. Make sure you have a good weekend. A happy, safe weekend. It's still crazy out there, y'all. Peace. The longest time, I wasn't being legit or for real with myself either, because that was a part of me. And even though I was doing it in secret. And then it just hit me.
And that's when it hit me. And that's when I became a geek. Finally, the sleeper has awakened. I am the prince of all geeks once again.